Hey guys, and welcome to another video of mine. Today I'm bringing you a Crysis 2 gameplay on the map Sanctuary. This was a team deathmatch to 75 kills. And in this commentary I will be talking about the DirectX 11 patch and the high resolution textures that came out. And so this game was recorded in DirectX 11 high resolution textures, but an extreme system spec, because even my system, which is like a better gaming system, not the best but one of the better, and it has a hard time running it at extreme. So it's not playable, at least not a first person shooter, in ultra spec at like 25 frames per second. I don't feel like I can get a lot of good scores in it while playing, so I'll just do it on extreme spec, where I have around 50 frames per second on my GTX 570. So I'll post on my system specs in the description below if you want to know them. But the DirectX 11 patch, as you can see right here, the dust. There's a wall, a lot more particles, I think that's how they call it, or dust when you shoot into something. That's what I really, really like in a game, so it gives a lot better effect, but again, it drains a lot of power from your GPU. So, if you would like to play an ultra with a decent spec, I've did some with a decent frames per second, like always 60 frames per second, not necessarily always. There are some moments that it won't always happen, like explosions and that sort. But if you really want to play at high spec, ultra, and with a lot of frames per second, you will need at least SLI 580s. You won't be able to run it at 60 frames per second without it. So, single GTX 590, I've heard from some people it's good enough to run the DirectX 11. But, like every card has a hard time running this game. It's just kind of weird. I mean, the technology just goes this far in a couple of months, and that one update can really slow down your computer while playing Crysis. So I think it's pretty awesome that humanity can do that. But yeah, let's leave that to the side now. Again, GTX 590. Definitely recommended, or two-way SLI 580s. I don't know that much about the ATI video cards, but I think at least something close to the 570 if you want to play it at least on extreme spec and decent frames per second. So yeah, again, the dust is awesome. Tessellation. The tessellation, you really see it's there, especially when you're looking like at the stones and the hallways I'm in right now. You see a bit of tessellation, not that much. I mean, if you look at Heaven benchmark, the stones at the beginning of it, it is quite some tessellation, I must say that. But like, you really have some, like, on the ground and in the walls. They also come with the high resolution texture pack. You see that there is a lot more tessellation, or they made it to be just like that. I don't know. It's really, really awesome. And this, it makes the game look really beautiful, but again, your GPU. If I don't turn off vertical sync, I'm not able to play it at a decent frame rate, because there also is a glitch or bug, I don't know what it is, but every time I boot up my Crysis on DirectX 11 with VSync on, the game just runs at like 10 frames per second. I turn it off, turn it back on, and then it runs at 60 frames per second. But so I'll just leave it off now, because I'm also getting a bit better frame rate, and I'm also frapsing a lot of my gameplay now on it, so I won't be able to reach higher than 60 frames per second at any point. So yeah, here you see it also like on these pillars here. A lot of tessellation, a lot of smooth lightning, reflection, shadows, the wall stuff, everything's just that Crysis, Crytek promised in the patch of DirectX 11. They really made it super, super, super good. No doubt about it, it's an awesome graphic detail. It makes the game even more enjoyable than it was before. So yeah, hope you guys liked it, hope you liked the gameplay, and yeah, see you next time. If you have any more questions or reactions to this video, leave it in the comments below. Bye bye.